1 plus 0 equals 1. Well, we all know that, but 1 plus 1 equaling 1? That's straight up whack. It's boolean algebra coming at you, fool. In fact, you better know the axioms if you don't wanna be a tool. Two-valued boolean algebra is where it's at, 'cause we're gonna show up on Mister Huntington's welcome mat. The closure property results in a 1 or a 0, and element x is our designated hero. X plus 0 equals x, and x times 1 equals x.
What is that?
Identity element trying to flex. We also got distribution and commutativity, but now I need to tell you that you look incredibly pretty. Wait, that's not the type of compliment I'm talking about, 'cause the complement of x is the opposite amount. Remember, pigs never act orderly. That's what you should ponder. Parentheses, not, and, or. Now that's the order. You figured out your logic, so I guess that's progress. But now you need to implement it, so let me profess. You need to use logic gates for your circuit design. There are 5 types of gates you should know. Let me define. An inverter outputs the complement of a bit from a single input. Has 2 transistors and only takes 1 nanosecond for its throughput. An AND gate multiplies 2 inputs in 2.4 for you. An OR gate will give an output from adding inputs 1 and 2. NAND and NOR give the complement of the previous operations. In fact, universal gates is their official declaration. 'Cause no matter what circuit you have, one thing remains true. Any kind of logic can be made with just those 2.
D-latch, yeah, I'm level sensitive. When the clock is 1, I'ma get the best of it. All these kids be asking what they're gonna be, I say, hold up, when the time is right and I'ma pass that D, I stay true to my bit. Riding off the clock with forgetting SR latch, I ain't got time for a glitch. Enabled equals 0, forget the D, I ain't caring. Enabled equals 1, you see me, I'm transparent. Tick tock on the clock, tell me when it's 1. I'll let you know what state is next when the time has come. Tick tock on the clock, tell me when it's 1. I'll let you know what state is next when the time has come.
Hey man, latches are fine and dandy and all, but like, I just have a small problem when multiple latches update unintentionally. I just wish there was some way I could store a stable bit value for D into the latch.
Just connect the clock to enable, boy.
Flippity flop and a flip flop. On the clock when the tick tocks. Disrespect the rules, don't you cry when you get docked off. Flip flops are more expensive, but that ain't nothing to me. I'm the master, you the servant. Just wait, you'll get your D. Latches are inconsistent. Flip flops give you the best bit. When your hardware breaks, latches say, son of a glitch. You gotta stay focused, always look ahead. 'Cause once clock turns 1, that's the rising edge. Patience is the key, don't get carried away. Once you get that D, update queue after delay. Depend on the next clock cycle for my fate, because everyone knows slow and steady wins the next state.
Set, reset, sequentials don't forget. When D equals 0, that's when I'ma reset. Set, reset, sequentials don't forget. When D equals 1, that's when I'ma be set.
Circuits have many states, so build an FSM. Use your logic gates and follow the diagram. Circuits have many states, so build an FSM. Build an FSM. Build an FSM. Circuits have many states, so build an FSM. Use your logic gates and follow the diagram. Circuits have many states, so build an FSM. Build an FSM. Build an FSM.